make something that could sound like you.
Wanna let a chance go by, cause you ain't been seen with a man so fly. Baby friend so fly, I can't go fly. Private cause I handle my B.I. They call me Candle Guy. Simply cause I am on fire. I hate to have to count
cancel my vacation, so you can't deny. I'm patient, but I ain't gon' try. You don't come, I ain't gon' die. Hold up, what you mean you can't go? Why? Me and your boyfriend, we ain't no tie. You say you wanna kick it when I ain't so high. Well, baby, it's obvious that I ain't your guy. I ain't gon' lie, I be in your space. Don't forget your face, I swear I will.
Same part, same bullet, anywhere I cheer.
Just bring with me a pair, I will.
I can see us holding hands, walking on the beach, our toes in the sand. I can see us on the countryside, sitting on the grass, like side by side. You could be my baby, when you make you my lady. Girl, you amaze me, ain't gotta do nothing crazy. See, all I want you to do is be my love.
Fresh Kid C, Fresh Kid C,
yes, sir.
Fresh Kid P, Fresh Kid T.
Oh yeah, we back.
Oh, and Zach Boone, by the way.
Yeah, Jones.
Yeah. Chitty Bang, and we pretty much amazing.
Can we hear your new song, please?
I got you.
Hey yo, I once was a kid, all I had was a dream. More money, more problems, when I get it, I'ma pile it up. Now I'm dope, want the bread, we can toast. So fresh, how we flow, everybody get the style
hey,
from
yo,
us.
I once was a kid with the other little kids. Now I'm ripping up shows and them fans going wild with us. Tell mommy I'm sorry, this life is a party.
Remember you was a kid,
up.
Reminisce days of the innocence. Now it's Chitty Bang, Google me the images. Follow me, I'm the leader. And when I park cars, I don't pay for the meter. I remember I was younger as a kid, it was the best. I used to touch on all the pretty girls in recess. I'm at my peak, yes, I won't leave yet. Cereal style, cereal aisle, I need checks. I can make these rappers run like a hard drill. Rock band, show you how the guitar feel. And I could care less how y'all feel. I got a flow to make a do a cartwheel. This is that good, just puff it and relax, bro. And you could get it free, don't worry about the tax, though. And Zap Fool, thank you for the crack. But I play it Ron Burgundy, I anchor on the track
hey,
like
yo, I
that.
I once was a kid, all I had was a dream. More money, more problems, when I get it, I'ma pile it up. Now I'm dope, want the bread, we get toast. So fresh, how we flow, everybody get the style
hey,
from
yo,
us. I once was a kid with the other little kids. Now I'm ripping up shows and them fans going wild with us. Tell mommy I'm sorry, this life is a party. I'm never growing up.
Can I please get a little bit of knowledge? Somebody tell Roth that I don't love college. Cause the real world's kinda like real world. And it's drama, so you are Svetlana. And I'm just a rhymer. Swimming in the water, trying to dodge the piranha and fly to Bahamas. Pretty little mama, titty in the spot where you at, Perlita. Show me what you got. They say, why you rapping for the kids for? I say my clothes come fitted, the link store. This summer you can catch me on a big tour. I'm high grade, I think they need to quiz more. And let me get with you, don't let the kid hit you. I'm the photo album Valletta has, big picture. The rule is, the dude is, so up, so Chuck, I'm a cool
hey,
kid.
Yo, I once was a kid, all I had was a dream. More money, more problems, when I get it, I'ma pile it up. Now I'm dope, want the bread, we can toast. So fresh, how we flow, everybody get the style
hey,
from us.
I
once was a kid with the other little kids. Now I'm ripping up shows and the fans going wild with us. Tell mommy I'm sorry, this life is a party. I'm like a growing up. I was a kid, all I had was a dream. More money, more problems, when I get it, I'ma pile it up. Now I'm dope, want the bread, we can toast. So fresh, how we flow, everybody get the style
hey,
from us. I was a kid with the other little kids. Now I'm ripping up shows and the fans going wild with us. Tell mommy I'm sorry, this life is a party. I'm never growing up.
Enjoyed that. We had a ton of fun doing this project for sure.
Yes.
And this, if you don't know,
I'll be there.
guess that's deja vu, but I thought this can't be true, cause I could remember everything inside of me. Just wanted to fit in. I was never one for pretenders. And everything I tried to be just wouldn't settle in. If I told you what I was, would you turn your back on me? And if I seemed dangerous, would you be scared? From the rest, do I have to run and hide? I never said that I want this. This burden came to me, and it's laid its home inside. If I told you what I was, would you turn your back on me? And if I seemed dangerous, would you be scared?
Touch isn't dark enough. That this problem lies in me. I'm only a man with a cable. You've got me. I'm taking a stand. keeping me awake.
It's the house telling you to close your eyes.
And some days I can't even trust myself.
It's killing me to see this way.
'Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry on.
Tell her that I miss our little talks.
Soon it will be over and buried with our past.
We used to play outside when we were young and full of life and full of love.
Some days I don't know if I am wrong or right.
Your mind is playing tricks on me, my dear.
'Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry on.
You're gone, gone, gone away. I watched you disappear. All that's left is a ghost of you. Now we're torn, torn, torn apart. There's nothing we can do. Just let me go, we'll meet again soon.
Now wait, wait, wait for me. Please hang. Safe to shore. Though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our body safe to shore.
Alright, welcome back to the Baltic Dota League Season 2. Today I'm bringing you Day of Trolls versus Kiparisiki, whatever you want to call them. And arguably, Kiparisiki are the best team in Lithuania. But that's arguable, of course. Today, the guy streaming is going to be TV Mantas, as you can see in the top right corner. And today I will actually have a co-caster. And joining me today is Yushi. Say hello.
Hey everybody.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing great, and I was so curious about this match because you're probably one of the best team in the whole Lithuania.
Sure. Is that all?
Yeah, I mean, like, I was so curious to find out how Kiparisiki were playing and stuff like that, so I'm glad I'm here.
Good. So, what do you think of the bans? Yushi, first I want to introduce Yushi. He is one of the players in this tournament with his team Renata plus 4. They're currently in the playoffs. I think they are undefeated yet, and they will not fall down to the loser's bracket yet. Is there even a loser bracket?
Yeah, there is.
Okay, so you're still in the winner's bracket, right?
Yeah, we won one match today.
Okay, good. So you're playing tomorrow, right?
Alright.
Okay then. So if you want to follow Yushi, you can just follow him in-game, which is going to be happening tomorrow. At what time?
I think it's going to be 8 p.m. Yeah, 8 p.m. probably.
Okay. So let's get back to this game. So there is Dire and Radiant, and they have banned 2 heroes of each other. So Dire bans Brewmaster and Invoker, two of middle heroes. Brewmaster being strong in the mid game and late game and even the early game with his clap and ulti.
Yeah.
Basically has the team fight control, the 5-man push that he can provide. So that's a really smart bans. What do you think about the Ogre Magi and the Tidehunter?
Yeah, I think Ogre is one of the like most picked hero in this tournament or some stuff like that, and he's really strong, I think, and banning that out is really smart too. I think he's good in late game, he's good in mid game, he's good in laning. He's kind of good in lane, I think. And Tidehunter, of course, is one of the best of laners, I think.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the statistics are, but I think Ogre is one of the top 3 pick ban heroes in this league itself.
And like Kiparisiki have like Elder Titan and Vengeful Spirit, and like Elder Titan can and Vengeful Spirit can like from full armor they can do like minus armor like -6 or something, and with Medallion automatically hero has like -12 armor with Avenge and Elder Titan because their aura and Wave of Terror actually stacks really well.
Yeah, against this team you basically have to get those aura items such as AC and Blades, which is not really a problem since Jakiro builds a Tranquils. So that goes into the extra armor. I think there's 4 armor from the boots. And I guess the rest picks are going to be those Vlads or AC carriers. And from the looks of it, the Dire is going for the 5-man push lineup. I'll get you in your face, get the tower, and I'm going to kill you under your tower and push. So they're going for this lineup from the picks, as Jakiro is a really popular pick right now since he gets buffed. Like, Ever since he's released, I think he had a buff. Never has he been nerfed. I think he has been nerfed.
Yeah, I think once
path,
maybe.
Yeah, the ice path was.
Yeah. Then everybody was maxing ice path in TA2 or TA3. I can't remember.
Between those times, yeah, Jakiro was one of the top supports with his ice path, but then he's got nerfed. And, well, there goes Jakiro. But now he's came back to the scene with dual breath buffs, with liquid fire being strong as hell.
Yeah, and as I was talking about Elder Titan and Vengeful Spirit, they just banned out the Dazzle, who can provide a tons of armor, like plus armor.
So, okay, so we talked about Jakiro. Let's talk about the bans, the rest of the bans, actually. Lycan and Centaur ban for the Dire team, of course. Lycan being... It actually could fit the Dire lineup quite well, of course.
And it's quite interesting that Kiparisiki banned the Void out, even though they had Vengeful Spirit and Elder Titan. I think these two heroes are quite good against him.
Well, I mean, if they are out of position, then the Chronosphere could easily decimate the whole team and allow.
Yeah, I suppose Void is a good hero.
Yeah, he could fit the Dari team so very well with his Chronosphere. He could also take a good team fight. He's a great pusher by just being there, being the threat of Chronosphere that could really punish down Kiborisuke. But Kiborisuke bans him, and there goes the Void pick.
Yeah, and the third pick, Zeus. That was quite interesting.
How so? Well, you know, you have to look at it this way. Zeus plus Natural Order, meaning you get
tons of damage.
Yeah, you basically get 100% that nuke damage, as well as the static field. So that actually deals a shitload of damage.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's an Omni Knight. For every spell you have, Omni Knight will be there with his repel.
Yeah, but like Omni Knight needs levels, and if Kiporisuke won't go for like push hero, I think they might get away with this.
Yeah, that's really a good possibility. Since Kiporisuke doesn't really have that concrete lineup, they can still go aggressive trialing, they can still put pressure on the Dari team, they can easily just control the game since all they picked was a Zeus who's decent in every lineup, because yeah. Since he's going mid, he's still gonna have those levels, right? He is gonna have that gold with his Arc Lightning spam. So he's a decent mid hero, I can say that. And he can join teamfights with his global ability. And Vengeful Spirit and Elder Titan are as well good heroes in the mid game, in the early game, since Vengeful Spirit and Elder Titan can both stomp and do damage.
Yeah, and in the late game.
Yeah, they're basically all around heroes. And with a bug pick, I am not sure. I think they're gonna go aggressive trialing and put Puck in the safe lane,
or they can maybe. I don't know. Well, maybe it's a Puck off lane.
When you look at the Dari team, they have only one stun, and that's Ice Path, which is pretty unreliable, and you can and really short duration actually. So you can just throw down your orb, and PA. Yeah. So classic combo: Omni, PA, Blink. Yeah. Slow, heal, there you are, like, event.
I feel like Radiant team needs some like tankier hero, like they're all so squishy right now, even though like especially when Elder Titan is going to support, I think.
Yeah, they need that one frontline tanker, otherwise you're just gonna get wrecked by the Death Prophet ulti or the Phantom Assassin.
Yeah.
But not to underestimate the damage output of Kiporisuke. If PA gets out of position and Omni Knight isn't there to protect his ass, then he's just gonna get blown up by stun, lightning bolt, buck, and other spells that Kiporisuke can throw out. So
yeah.
Omni Knight has to just basically babysit PA whole game long. Also, PA having a repel basically means that he can save 4,000 gold by not buying a BKB, although in the late game, I think he is gonna buy that BKB, and Omni Knight is just gonna use the repel on Death Prophet, so she doesn't have to buy a BKB.
Yeah, and Radiant team doesn't have a like a defusal buyer. Like they don't have a hero who can carry the defusal. Like I mean, in the late game, of course, like support is gonna buy that, but you have to have like one in mid game, I think.
Sure, there are heroes that can buy though. Defusals like Puck can pick up it, as his core is really just dagger and yules. Yeah. After that, it's just anything you want, really. So yeah. Defusal is not out of the question. And then there's, well, they lack a carry, right?
I thought of Sven because it's really good against Death Prophet. Maybe he's like is a frontliner and has lots of armor, is tanky and stuff like that.
Yeah, bonus armor can actually be really helpful. But still, there's this thing called Guardian Angel. So I think they need a defusal carrier. And we see Venomancer and Ember Spirit banned, since Ember Spirit. There we go. As I said, defusal carrier. He is a really great defusal carrier. Also can go toe-to-toe with BA. Of course, Spectre is that hero that needs to farm.
Yeah. And I feel like in the late game, one-on-one, maybe PA wins. I don't know. What with the Elder Titan and Vengeful Spirit and Zeus bug? Of course not.
Of course, there's ability of team to help them, but in the end, if there's a 1v1 team fight, I mean 1v1 man fight between PA and Spectre, I would like to say Spectre wins, due to dispersion and desolate, but it all comes down to the team, and this is not a 1v1 game. So 3 seconds, 2 seconds, and there we go, Doom.
Pick. Oh, Doom.
Yeah.
So greedy. Like Omni Knight support and Doom, like so greedy. I think those two supports, Jakiro Omni Knight need levels so bad. I feel.
Well, here's the thing. Kiparistike isn't really looking for that early game push.
Yeah.
So they have time to farm the Doom. They have time to have that.
They have greedy supports too. Oh, Elder Dieden might not be support. No, it's gonna be support.
Okay, give me a sec. Have that slow. Okay, we can do this, I guess. So, apparently there's a pause for some reason. I'm not sure why. And there we go, unpause. Not even asking whether or not there's going to be a ready or not. So, let's introduce the teams. I will go for the Radiant, you go for the Dire, and on the Radiant side we have Puck playing Bacardi, or vice versa. Kozlo CZ, which means he's Penguin, playing Elder Titan. We have Fabian playing the Zeus, we have Quell on the Carry Spectre, and Deluxe, sponsored by Pornhub, playing the Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, that's a that's so favorite sponsor.
Yeah.
So often seen. So on the Dire side, we have a Kowalda, who will be playing by Death Prophet. Jakiro will be played by Q11. Mindus is gonna be on Phantom Assassin. Veekston is gonna be handling that Doombringer and
Death Ward though.
Yeah.
Whoa.
And Megax is gonna be playing Omni Knight.
Yeah, so they came to the lane pretty quickly, but not quick enough, as Buck already laid down the observer ward, but it actually doesn't matter since they dewarded it. So good win for DOT team, as to a great start as Bacardi
will not have. The rune.
Let's see what
like Radiant is getting it.
Oh, it's a greed rune. The Demon gets the better end of it. He's gonna whack Vengeful Spirit a bit.
Oh, it's actually really good for Doom, because it's like dual. I guess he can't do anything, but he will get more than staying against two supports.
Oh, look, it's a 2-1-2 lane. So there's other Titan being has his boots. Will go for Soloing and Tranquils.
Yeah, and maybe Yules later on.
Who do you think is gonna win middle lane?
I feel like Zeus. I'll give a little bit of an edge to Zeus, I think.
Yeah, his Arc Lightning is an easier spam to spell than Carrion Swarm.
It has like more range, I think.
Yeah, it's a longer range.
Yeah.
Well, you can cast it at longer range than Crypt Swarm, but in the end, I think Crypt Swarm has the longer path.
Yeah.
So the top lane is going to be actually annoying for the Dire team, the Radiant team, as the Jakiro is gonna just spam his Look of Fire on the enemy team while Mindus just throws down those daggers.
But I feel like they're doing a great job to like stopping PA from farming. Like every minute you can stop PA's farm is really good, I think. And they will get more Vita Puck than staying 1-on-3, I think.
I'm actually not certain why Omni Knight is not there to. Well, actually, never mind. Omni Knight can't really do anything in the lane, and he's doing the best he can, which is take the balls, deny the XP.
That XP, yeah.
Yeah.
In the mid lane, we're already seeing twice. Zeus is actually has twice as much CS as Death Prophet.
Well, when you start with that greedy build of two Iron Branches with.
Yeah,
you basically you basically have 600 gold from the start. That's annoying to play with. and you get those easy lessons with your Arc Lightning spell, as Death Prophet doesn't really right-click well enough at the start of the game, since it's attack animation and the projectile is not that fast. We see Doom has his ice armor, which will increase his armor against the Wave of Terror, and an Angel Spirit that just grabs the Invis Rune. But she's level 1, she can't really use
like
it.
Every lane is going very well for Radiant team.
Yes. I feel like they're not getting much done in the top lane. Of course, there's nothing else to do besides just farm, but I think they could kill the Elder Titan, which is actually going home. But in the end, I think they could easily snag the kill.
I feel like they could have put it, like, they could have put the lanes differently, maybe. Maybe PA mid and Death Prophet top, I'm not sure.
Well,
maybe dual lanes too.
Death Prophet is a mid hero. She needs the rune control, otherwise she's not gonna have enough sustain for the mana spells and stuff. Fabian getting some hits. Taking harassment. Kiparisica career still not upgraded at 3 minutes part. I guess they just don't feel the need for it. Or nope, actually, Vengeful Spirit has no items whatsoever. Look at her gold. She's not even 220 gold.
She's stacking and pulling all day long.
Top lane, they're intercepting the double pull. Not actually allowing the Omni Knight to get his EXP and farm.
Yeah. I think even though it's 2-on-3 situation, I think Radiant team has more chance of killing the Dire team, because they have Bug Burst and they have Elder Titan, and Dire team has like nothing. Omni Knight does a lot of damage, but he needs that levels, and like first level purification does like nothing. Maybe on the third level.
Well,
not sure.
The Radiant team is gonna have much better use of gold that they get from winning the lanes. So, in order to win the game, well, I mean, Death Prophet is basically using the lane for EXP at this point, not really that much for assets. As if Zeus decides to go gank, which he is gonna do, since Lightning Bolt, whatever the second spell is, actually it deals a ridiculous amount of damage. So Death Prophet is gonna do that push, and hopefully he's gonna take down the tower. But his skill build is actually really dumb, and bottom lane, Doom dies, almost killing the Specker, underestimating the amount of damage that Vengeful Spirit can do. Actually, Specter went for 2 levels in Desolate, and he was tanking basically whole damage. Mid lane.
Oh, in mid lane.
Yeah, I'm missing kills left and right and center.
And I think Radiant team had 100% rune control. I think they picked up every single rune in this game.
I saw Deathrock picking up a greed rune, which is bounty.
Oh yeah, but like Venge was picking up like 3 or 2 runes in bottom, and Zeus was picking up like two.
Elder,
so almost 100% rune control from Radiant side. It's really good.
Yeah, the rune control is one thing how to win a game, and if you look compare farm from Spectre and the PA,
PA is not getting anything.
She's basically being
exorcism,
doubled.
Exorcism in the rune.
He can easily kill him. He's dead.
Oh yeah, nice kill.
Fabian took down the bounce rune, so he's not actually that great. Ice Bath from Chihiro
Zeus
trying
might
to
be
do
dead
it.
Too.
Ice Bath, is it gonna hit? It should hit. What is he doing? It hits, and
Here's
there
one.
He goes.
Nice. Nice double kill.
That's
they
what
needed
I said
that
about,
so bad.
Yeah, that's what I said about Dash Prophet. He actually needs just EXP. Well, he needs farm as well, but EXP is basically what he needs in the middle lane to be able to put down ridiculous amount of damage. Bottom lane, Vengeful Spirit going on the Doom.
No, Spectre doesn't have mana. Oh, actually, the Dread Swap.
The stun. The stun happens, the slow as well, and Doom should be a no, actually, yep.
Oh.
Zeus just responds and snags the kill. Without the ulti, I don't think they could have gotten it, actually.
Yeah.
So, good awareness by the Zeus. I guess the Kiparisica were like, Zeus, throw your ulti, easy kill. Easy Katka.
absolutely.
It's really sad to see a Trilane lose against a dual lane so bad, but I guess that's what you get for having a Omni-Knight as your support. I mean, Jakiro is a really good support since he can harass easily, but Omni-Knight provides literally nothing to the lane.
Actually, Pug has more for CS than a PA, so that's really sad.
I guess there's not really anything they can do since Elder Titan is going to counter-initiate easily. Some harassment done to Puck, not too much.
Actually, Omni-Knight is getting quite good levels.
Ooh, Death Prophet going back to base, really has nothing. Potentially
could
die. And
already 8 minutes in, there's 2,000 gold net difference between these two teams.
And there's no Midas, so the gold advantage is actually really strong, as Midas usually provides nothing.
Yeah.
By the looks of it, Spectre is going to have like
top lane.
Oh, there's a bolt on the
Jakiro. Ultimate Zeus ultimate. Yeah.
Lots of kills going. Omni-Knight goes down. Will Bacardi die?
Might be dead too.
Stomp. Buck ulti, and there goes triple PA. Kill. So that's what I was saying. Basically, Zeus goes ganking. DP actually wanted to push middle, but she couldn't really do much since there's Eventual Spirit. So good rotation by the Kiparisuke team, allowing Zeus to snag triple kill and Eventual Spirit to get those really needy levels.
Sure. Top tower is under attack. Doom is catching up in the jungle. He has 2 deaths already, and Spectre is completely free farming. Might go for the drums. No, he just went straight to the defusal.
Straight defusal. I would have preferred him going for a Radiance. Since
I suppose he wants to.
Yeah, but for the when you're having such a free farm lane, you usually want to go for that greedy item, which is Radiance. And he could have easily gotten it by 15 minutes. And with that Radiance, he would have been just powerhousing it down. Nobody's daring to go to this lane. He could have easily gotten like 15 minutes
through
Radiance. I mean, sure, he can join teamfights now quite easily, but he could have farmed Diffusal so much faster with the Radiance.
I think he won't even go for Radiance after Diffusal.
He might. He might go for a Diffusal, but it's unlikely. I mean, for Radiance.
Yeah.
So, minute 10, no towers down. Doom is going to go to the lane. Probably will die again. Going to the
haunt
on the top lane to stomp on 3. Crit from Mind is wrecking, but Fabian with his ulti, with his lightning storm, just takes down the triple kill again. One more rotation, as well as haunt, and there goes the safe lane.
Yeah, they'll probably get a tower too. Oh no, they won't.
Nah, they won't. But this Death Prophet should join teamfights as well.
Yeah, he could have TP'd. I think he had a TP. He has it now.
He has a TP, but I don't think he can actually do much since they just got bursted down so fast that TP would have been too late.
Yeah.
It's quite worrying when a mid-late game team is actually winning the early game, where you should have already pushed down like 2 towers at least. Middle lane, Q11. Getting wrecked. The Echo Stomp is going to miss.
Oh, he is dead.
He's dead, yeah. The Ice Pad hat catches nothing. And ATP wasted, basically. But Fabian, Doom catches him out. Doom is used.
Death Prophet. He doesn't have Orb of Venom. Oh, he might run him out.
Nah, he's dead.
Oh, look at those stacks in the Radiant side.
There I think they could. Ooh.
Exorcism.
Exorcism is used to get the kill. Okay, Elder Titan doesn't have mana for the stomp. Will the Lix die? No, he won't. Blink from Bacardi already for the offlane lane.
There's a stack too.
There is the defusal. So basically, what the Radiant support did was stack the jungle. Look at these stacks.
Yeah,
that's like 3 stacks
all over the place.
4 stacks in this lane, 2 stacks here, 2 stacks here, 2 stacks here. That's a lot of farm for Diffusal, Blade, Spectre. Although, with all the kills he's been in, he has been in, he could have easily have an Irradiance. At least the Sacred Relic, yeah, at this point.
And he's going for the Manta, I think, with that Band of...
Yeah, for sure. Well, I guess he doesn't like Spectre. I mean, he doesn't like Radiance, or he just wants to end the game faster. Which is totally fine, but Radiance just allows you to do so much more than a Diffusal. Just, it... Look at all these stacks and how he can easily just take them down with Radiance, and how he cannot do it with Diffusal.
Yeah. I think Zeus will take them out. Maybe Puck.
Both of those people can easily take him down, but it doesn't matter really.
Top is, I think, yeah, their team will push.
Looks like Top is in trouble again. Ogre, I mean, Omni Knight getting chased down by the Spectre.
Oh, Blink.
Ooh, already Blink, nice. Or will he catch him out? No, this, the Dream Coil is gonna catch Phantom Assassin. Heal. Nice.
Oh, what a repel.
Nice repel. Quell just jumps in, uses Diffusal. There goes the Phantom Assassin. There goes the Omni Knight.
And already 6,000 net worth.
The Death Prophet catching, coming to the wrong place at the wrong time as Bacardi and Fabian are going to chase him down. No more mana for the orbs. But does, is it needed?
Oh, one hit.
Nope.
Oh, it's just my hit catch.
Stomp misses. Death Prophet is just too fast. But Doom is not the correct place at the right time.
Yeah.
He may have let Death Prophet be alive, but he paid with it with his own death. Jesus, I can't talk today. Mindus TPing in versus... Well, they can actually get the kill on the Spectre if he's not careful.
Yeah, I think they don't know where everyone is. Oh, they do.
A heal. Will Quell survive? Nope. That was out of position.
Might even get tower. Tower is low. 500 HP. Radiant side.
Yeah, they have 4 people here. They can easily take it. That was
going for drums.
That was really strange from the Spectre. Feeding like that. Looks like the Radiant team doesn't want to give it away. They're coming. They lift the tower.
Opok has a Mox Silence.
It's a nice 3 Oh, Jesus Christ. The Guardian Angel comes, but it doesn't ignore magic damage.
Oh, he even uses Exorcism, but he's dead. He's dead.
That Zeus is not
gonna... Oh, a triple kill.
Zeus is
really
not gonna...
nice play from Radiant team.
Yeah, Zeus is not gonna die, and... Well, 4 for nothing. 4 for 1, actually.
Oh, Venge died. Didn't even notice.
Yeah, I don't think he actually cares about that. He's gonna be like, space created.
Yeah.
Since Spectre didn't really need to jump in. But he uses the jump now and Doom is dead.
Puck is actually doing so much work. Has 4 kills and 11 assists.
That's
really
like
great play from him.
15 of the 20 kills he has he been in. That's the same as the Zeus, actually.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, Zeus, I can just soul type, I guess.
Yeah, that's actually easier to jump in. But there's already 2 daggers on the Radiant team. There's the Yasha from Spectre, so his physical DPS is actually really strong at this point. Even though PA has 2 levels of Blur, it's not going to help you against all the bursts that the Radiant team has.
Absolutely. I feel like maybe Doom will... I don't know how to come back from such game.
Ooh, the heal misses and Fabian is allowed to run away. Ooh, that's a golem to the what's this called? The Rafael on the Death Prophet. Doom on the Puck, and there goes the Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, so coil for Doom cooldown and they got Venge, so...
They need it.
Girl victory. Yeah.
The team DOT really needs every kill, although it's sad that they get the only kill on the Vengeful Spirit, but they need...
I get tower? No, I think they can't.
Ooh, Mindus being too aggressive.
Grit!
Oh, that damage though.
Yeah.
The static field doing work, as well as the lightning bolt.
And
too aggressive.
This is Midas, but they get the cut tower and...
They got tower and... Not worth it. be thinking he's a god, but Rebel is only 8 seconds long, not that long.
Look, I don't know how to come back from such a game. It's really hard for Dire's side.
I mean, if it were a lower team than Kyparissa, then it could be possible, but when you have basically a top team in Lithuania versus this kind of situation, there's really no comeback. There has to be so many mistakes made by Kyparissa.
Yeah, and you're relying on mistakes by your enemy.
And that's never a good thing to rely.
Yeah. Oh, they might get top tower, so...
Yeah.
Overall, they're getting two towers. It was actually really weird. Puck didn't get damage from a dagger, but he got slowed from it, so that's weird.
The tower goes down, the dagger, Elder Titan harassment didn't really do much, as they get a pickoff on Puck, which wasn't really that expected, because he got silenced.
So. So suddenly a 1,000 gold change and 2,000 experience change, so...
That's really... Well, they need... Like 15 of those. Fabian going on the Death Prophet silence catches the Zeus.
Oh, he's dead.
Oh. This is the point where you scream, "Team, where are you? Team!"
Yeah.
TP plus.
Oh, is Zeus just playing with his ultimate and canceling it?
Sentry ward, not the normal ward drop down. Not sure what that accomplishes. Q11 looks like he's gonna meet with Eventual Spirit. Nope, their paths do not cross. Actually, I wonder what this Spectre is gonna go for after the Man Style. I guess a tree, right? There's nothing else to go after Man Style. Tower Deny on the Doom. Boom, there goes him. Actually, Mindus with the Repel, with the drums. Use the drums.
Oh, nice swap.
Swap saves the Zeus life, but not for long as he goes down. Will he go down? Actually, he goes, but not before he gets an ulti. I mean, the
Lightning Bolt. Ornn is gonna like finish Phantom Assassin, I think. Yeah,
yes, he will die.
Oh, stick!
Yep.
Oh, nice.
Waiting for the last time. Now, Quell is in position. I mean, out of position. Drums used on the Death Prophet. Will Quell die? No, he just runs away from the spirits. Too fast.
And in the meantime, Elder Titan just got tower from top lane. So 2-for-1 and a tower exchange, and
they didn't ever kill the gank yet, actually. Although it's sad that Puck and Spectre didn't die, but they got the Zeus, which was the second net worth?
Probably.
Yeah, the second net worth and the Radiant Hume.
Didn't they get a Venge?
Maybe, I don't think so. I don't think he died there. But anyway, Phantom Assassin has now 2k gold. He can work for his Basher or Lifesteal or whatever the hell he wants, actually.
On top lane, Invis, Elder Titan.
Scouts out everyone.
And look at the Doom's armor now. It's gonna be like minus 6. Oh, he doesn't have much armor anyways.
And now the stomp.
Minus 8, actually.
D double.
Yeah.
There goes the Doom. Burst it down easily. Now he's in position, not out of position. He's gonna TP out, the armor though, the right clicks. He needed Guardian Angel and then TP, but there's a swap.
That combo
looks so
really
grim.
Good.
It looks so grim for the Radiant team.
Yeah.
There's not really much they can do. Blink. Blink disjoints the dagger, but. And he will survive, actually. No buts about it.
Actually, Phantom Assassin went for Sanj, so... SNY?
Halberd at this point.
Maybe.
Sanj and Yasha wouldn't be that bad, but you definitely need better items than Sanj and Yasha at this point.
I feel like she... Yeah... She needed to go for Vlad's, maybe. Like, that armor.
Oop, the courier, it's dead.
Yeah, it's dead.
Doom pushing out, could have doomed already the Zeus. Uses his stuff.
Oh, has Blink already.
No. Go, Blink, Doom, now. Haunt goes in.
Silence
Doom walks into two. Oh, there goes two people, actually.
And Mindus is gonna die too.
Mega X being chased by three. And this is GG, really. There's nothing else to say.
Yeah, there's nothing else they can do.
The race car build from the Elder Titan. Ooh, it's disgusting, really. What a stomp. Literally, a stomp with Echo Stomp. Oh, the buns. There goes the base. Well, with his Manta style and 1,700 gold. Icebath trying to delay the push, but not really much happening. As Quell takes down the tower. But they cannot take down the Rax because they just respawn too fast.
And Puck is going for the Dagon.
You know, when you have power treads on agility and on intelligence, you don't usually survive that long. So, I mean, they should definitely swap his treads more often. Well, looks like the Radiant team is looking for the tier 2s now. And they see that Mindus is now solo.
Doom,
swap, stun, stomp, dead. Zero armor, not much luck.
Actually.
Yeah, not that lucky. Looks like Vengeful is going for her defusal as well.
Yeah, so they just want defusals against that Omni-Knight, but like Omni-Knight is 0-7. He doesn't accomplish like anything, and I feel like even without those defusals, he probably still do the same. Like maybe, I don't know.
Oh, Jahiro just gets bursted down, and the fresh ward gets dewarded. Everything
those
that
Dagons
goes
actually,
wrong.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Everything that goes wrong is going wrong for the Dire team.
Yeah. And DOT. Those Dagons actually do a lot of damage with Elder Titan Sora, Natural Order.
Everything does a lot of damage with Natural Order. It's basically pure damage at this point.
Yeah, maybe even more.
A single hero has 25% magical resistance.
Yeah,
and the Elder Titan gives 33% of the reduction.
It's actually more than pure damage.
Well, when you think about it, do you lose 33% of the 25% that you have? Or do you lose... Basically, the 25% is the 100% and 33% is that... Do you get my idea?
Yeah, but still can't count.
I mean, it's 67% should be, but it's not... I'm not sure, actually. Whatever, doesn't matter.
Oh,
Doom,
Elder
Titan. He's gonna use himself, the silence, everything's going on. Doom on the...
Doom on Puck, actually really good Doom.
Really good Doom, but he goes down either way. Doom is not dispelled by everyone else.
Yeah, but it's like, they did...
Splitter is gonna miss, but it allows Q11 to... die. Yeah. Everyone's dead. They're all dead!
Phantom Assassin is alive, I suppose. Well, like, they did everything they could, but, like, it's too late, I think, to make a great place. It was really good Doom and stuff like that, but they're just too... The Radiant team is way too ahead, I think.
That's called snowballing, really.
Yeah.
When you win the early game, you just snowball from there. When a team that is supposed to push only has two towers, that's
against
not good
all
news.
Towers, like, yeah.
That's not good.
And they don't even have like better late game for to fight for. Okay, I
Eventual
know.
Spirit getting caught out. But it's only Eventual Spirit, doesn't really matter, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Yeah, I think that's basically game over. The heroes that the Dire team are really not that good at coming back, although PA can really do some damage, but with the build she is going at this point.
And like, I feel still Radiant team has better late game. Like,
yeah.
Like, I am not sure, but I feel like Phantom Assassin pick didn't accomplish much. And, like, I don't know. You could have picked something. Maybe, I don't know. Like, you should have just fought 5 man, maybe. I don't know.
It's really hard to find man when the Puck has a dagger.
Yeah. It really is.
Yeah. Well, Kubalda getting sees the Pavilion
Wow.
Stomp is gonna miss. Eels from Fabian. Eels from Kuvalda. Eels from the Elder Titan. No, Dice Path stops him. The Blink. Oh my god. Our Splitter, everything on the Phantom Assassin Doom.
But the Haunt, but the Haunt.
Haunt is gonna get one kill. Is he gonna get the second one? No, he's not even gonna get a single one.
Whoa, actually, Phantom Assassin survived because of due to the heal of Omni-Knight. Wow, but still, two deaths.
Well, if Pell had paid notice, he could have easily gotten two kills, but in the end, two are down, and I think this is game over with this push, although it seems like DOT wants to defend Exorcism as Bob.
The one Dagon and he's dead.
Rip. Yeah. Rip in pieces.
The Baroness. Yeah.
They're trying to push out, try to slow down the push. Yules on Omni Knight, Repel on the PA, doing some crits, but definitely not enough as he goes down from the right click of Quell.
And it's over. So over.
So over, yeah. GG is called Kuvalda. And Kiparisa takes down the first game. Or is it the only game?
No, it's best of three.
Okay, so best of three. Kiparisa is one game ahead now. Do not change your channel if you're watching on YouTube, or just wait a few minutes on Dota TV. We'll be right back. And see ya, guys. Thank you for watching.
air like it's good to be alive. And I'm a famous rapper even when the paths are all crooked. I can show you how to do-si-do. I can show you how to scratch a record. I can take apart the remote control, and I can almost put it back together. I can tie a knot in a cherry stem. I can tell you about Leif Erikson. I know all the words to De Colores, and I'm proud to be an American. Me and my friends are platypus. Me and my friend made a comic book, and guess how long it took. I can do anything that I want, cause look, I can keep rhythm with no metronome. No metronome, no metronome. And I can see your face on the telephone. On the telephone, on the telephone. Look at me, just called to say that it's good to be alive. In such a small world, I'm all curled up with a book to read. I can make money, open up a thrift store. I can make a living off a magazine. I can design an engine, 64 miles to a gallon of gasoline. I can make new antibiotics. I can make computers survive aquatic conditions. I know how to run a business, and I can make you want to buy a product. Movers, shakers, and producers. Me and my friends understand the future. I see the strings that control the system. I can do anything with no resistance, cause I can lead a nation with a microphone. With a microphone, with a microphone. And I can split the atom of a molecule. Of a molecule, of a molecule.
Team pick.
And welcome back to the Baltic Dota League Season 2 games. Today, we're bringing you the games. I am TV Months, as shown in the top right, and joining me is my buddy, Yoshi.
Hey everybody. Once again.
Once again, yeah. We come back for the game 2 of Kiparese versus Day of Throws, DOT. Kiparese taking a convincing game 1.
Yeah, very convincing. Very convincing.
Yeah, very convincing. We see Day of Throws banned the other Titan. I keep mixing Titan and Spirit. I'm not sure why.
Because it's all about spirits.
Yeah. Elder Titan looks like they do not want to deal with the Elder Titan anymore, and sanking into Ogre Magi and Jakiro. Two supports picked down for Kiparese, and if I had to make a choice, I'd say they're gonna go Ogre Magi and Jakiro bottom lane. I mean top lane, off lane.
Yeah, they might. First pick sanking, it's really
bold. They already have a strategy in mind with the sanking.
But they did their homework, they banned out Elder Titan.
They just don't want to play against him anymore. He's too strong.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. So, they're waiting now for their pick. I'm gonna guess it's going to be Eventual Spirit, as she works quite well against Ogre Magi, although you can't really swap outside of Fire Blast multicast. You're gonna go in, and no problem.
Yeah, you might
Lone Druid and Die Hunter bans from Kibarisay. It looks like they do not want the Die Hunter ability of Ravaging. And Day of Throws goes for the Rat Prophet.
Wow. It's really interesting. Draft from them.
Actually, not really according to the metagame, is it now?
No, it's not.
Yeah. Nature's Prophet going for the Rat build, I assume. Sanking just split pushing as well. He can easily do that.
Ban and Necrolite, they might go for Spectre again.
What does Necrolite and Spectre have in common?
I think in late game, like Necrolite does a lot of damage to Spectre.
Due to the aura?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Since he's so tanky.
But if you go for such an easy game like they had last game, does the game really go to the late game?
No, no, but I'm not sure.
Yeah. So we have the Zeus, the Thinker ban. Why Thinker ban? I'm not sure. Personally, I hate the Thinker. So in any game that he's not picked, that's good enough for me.
The Zeus ban.
Huh. I guess they just. Well, they. I guess they're. They just do not want to see the Zeus ulti, Nature ulti.
Invoker, I think Quell is gonna be handling Invoker this game.
Well, looks like we're gonna have a fast-paced game with Invoker. I really hope he's going for the Yule, Sunstrike, Meteor, Deafening Blast combo, as it's always entertaining to see. And actually, it's so easy to do, actually, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, with the combination, you deal around 1000 magical pure damage. Half of the Sunstrike, the other one is just strike.
It's really to land when you have something like an ogre and
or Shikiro. It's really easy if against Nature's Prophet as well. He can't really run away, he just has to tank it. I guess if he has Nature, the Furion summons, which are the Treants, I forgot the name, the Treants around him, he can easily tank the Sunstrike.
But yeah, he can split.
But that's not enough when you're having an Exhort Invoker, as Nature's Prophet isn't really known to have a lot of HP.
Yeah, he's so squishy. And Witch Doctor, so... Like, these supports... I mean, Sanking and Witch Doctor, there's no synergy, they can't gank.
Well,
I don't know.
They can gank, but it's difficult. But in the end, I think Invoker is actually not gonna go for the Exhort, and he will go for the Quest Fights.
Yeah, because of the Drow Ranger aura.
Yeah, so because of the Drow Ranger, also the EMP is going to be really annoying to Witch Doctor and Sanking. Also, the Cold Snap is going to be really annoying to Nature's Prophet.
I'm wondering what they're gonna pick. Like, I thought of Visage obviously, but I think they need another core on Radiant side. No, on the Dire side.
On the Dire. Well, maybe a Clockwork to be the frontliner.
Maybe.
Really, when you look at this lineup, I see two tanky heroes, two not so much, but one of them is mobile, so he doesn't really need to be tanky. And a Slark. He will go right in. But I'm afraid that he's going to have a bad time, since Gust is going to not allow him to right click for a bit.
But the Dire side has a draft that can push really fast, and that the push comes like around 10 minutes, right? So, like around that time, if they won't deal with the Sanking, they won't crush lanes and stuff like that. I think Sanking will have his blink, and they might do something. Like, they might even fight. I don't know. I'm not sure.
The Dire team can easily push at minute 6 when Drow is 6 with Jakiro Liquid Fire. It's easily achievable, but Sanking is going to be that one factor in which Kiparisa should take a notice at, since the dagger and epicenter combo is really strong against Drow Ranger, who is really, really squishy. Invoker can be squishy as well if he doesn't have good items. Although, if he goes for Yules again, well, reduce the damage from Sanking, or even better, just not allow him to TP, to blink.
Actually, Luna ban is so odd.
Sure. Devil. Yeah. Looks like Jakiro.
What if putting Jakiro or Ogre into offlane and picking Visage's support or Revenge, and just the damage is insane, but Dazzle is good too, I think.
So as I said, it's going to be Ogre and Jakiro in the offlane.
Yeah.
they're actually not that killable, and they can easily sustain.
And tanking is gonna be jungling, or like he needs levels to do something in lane, so he's gonna have easy time definitely against Fish Doctor and Slark.
He's going to be in the lane at least 3 minutes in until he's level 3 or until he gets.
Terribly, wow, it's so greedy against this lineup.
So they're actually gonna run Slark in the middle lane from the looks of it.
Or maybe
Smoker.
Yeah.
Well, I introduced the Dire team last game, so you introduce them right now.
Okay, so. Wait, what?
You introduced the Dire team.
Oh, okay. So, Kiparisuke, and we have a Bacardi playing as Jakiro and going to the bot lane with his boots. The Lixian is sponsored by Pornhub, is playing the Dazzle. Actually, Fabian is playing Invoker. I thought of Quell, but Quell is going to be handling Drow Ranger and Ogre Magi, played by
Penguin.
Kozlo. Yeah, Penguin.
Yeah, and on the Radiant team, we have Q11 on the Sand King, Mega X on the Witch Doctor, Mindus playing the Terrorblade, Kowalda playing the Slark, and last but not least, Wixton playing the Nature's Prophet, who surprisingly doesn't have a single region item for himself. So looks like he's going to be dodging the lane once again.
And surprisingly, didn't level up his Treants to start off.
He really doesn't have anything. If it was a lane 1 versus 1, then he can level TP to help, I'm not sure. But this build is really strange, I want to say, because you have clarity and no HP. He may or may not just get creeps here and just walk all the way here.
Yeah.
Until but here.
I feel like Dire team outmaneuvering Radiant team once again. Like, they putting double lanes and they know they're gonna. Their offlaner still doesn't. Won't get anything, even though it's one support, and they know that their offlane will have more because of another support, so. It's actually a really smart choice from them, I think. Once again.
It looks like the Furion is doing what I said.
Yeah.
But the Lix can actually drag the creeps here. If they spawn out, they're gonna get blocked.
Gonna blocked.
Yeah. So he's stopping for a bit. Run, my friend. And he gets a double pull. The lane is gonna push in right.
It's actually
there.
Really smart from Drow to pull out slain ward. I mean, creeps.
Yeah.
But still, some XP, some gold to Nature's Prophet. But he's gonna do like it once or twice, and he doesn't have any mana. Have any region.
He got clarity. Oh, he actually used the clarity.
Yeah, so it's not gonna be forever spamming those trees and pulling it.
Man, this leveling up the Metamorphosis doesn't have his Arcana. Why wouldn't you have Arcana for the hero? Top lane, actually. Vexen getting right clicked by
dead.
Pornhub. He's dead. I meant the Licks, not Pornhub.
Like, Dazzle didn't even skill this poison touch, but still managed to just right-click Nature's Prophet, and what you did mention in draft, he's so squishy, he can't do anything, and... Yeah.
Slark is getting beaten middle once again.
And Invoker actually going for Exhort, not Vex, so... Weird.
So, he's either going for the Yule's combo or the Necrominicons.
Overall, it's still a lot of damage with the Drow Aura. It doesn't matter if you have attack speed or not. Like, still a lot of damage.
Yeah. Fabian being right-clicking. Sun Strike.
Oh, nice.
Right-click.
Nice.
Ooh, that's a really,
really
needed kill.
Nice.
That's a really needed kill for the Slark.
Yeah, it's... Yeah.
The Lix was just too slow and wasn't in time. Bottom lane. Ice Bat stun on Mendes. The illusions. Actually failing to block, and Mendes, will he survive? Yes, he will. Ignite doing damage.
Nice heal.
One more right click. Liquid Fire, will he die? No, he won't. As the heal, and he actually salved through that, so he doesn't actually have that much health remaining. The region. Slark survives. No Sun Strike to kill him. Top lane, Nature's Prophet being harassed. Cannot show his face in the lane.
What
I think
lane?
You're bottom lane. Oh. Nope, not much then. Actually, I spat the Ignite stun. And
but the heal again.
Metamorphosis actually is used. The stun bounces on Bacardi, but actually doesn't really do much there. Oh well. He still needs that range form to farm, so it's not really that much of a waste. But when you're not getting blasts, that's not what you have to do.
Yeah, and Jakiro's and Ogre still getting their levels, and like Nature's Rabbit, like Nature's Rabbit is level 2, while Jakiro and Ogre are level 3 already, so.
Well, that's what you get for dying as Nature's Prophet at level
yeah.
1 to a freaking support Dazzle, man.
Yeah.
Friendly games being played by Penguin and the Terrorblade.
And Nature's Prophet is just going jungle.
Yeah, that's
he knows
what
he can't get anything.
That was what he was supposed to do, actually.
Yeah,
but... Ooh, the D ward actually misses the ward itself. So, unlucky there. Wait, do observe wards last for 6 minutes or what?
No.
No, they're. The timing. What? Never mind. Ooh, Dazzle dies.
Slog
dies.
Second solo
Dazzle.
Kill. And again, perfect rune control for Kiparisiki team.
Yeah, they valued the runes as they're really good. And Q11 just going to the lane.
And Megax is gonna go down to Liquid Fire and Ignite. Just so much slow.
So much DPS, DOT
yeah.
damage, damage over time damage. Slark not having the best of games, has 1 kill but only 7 CS meanwhile, and Walker with Exhort with the Drow Aura has 24.
Yeah. Slark doesn't even has his bottle. Oh, he doesn't.
So they're doing the same mistakes they did last game, which is lucid laning phase.
But they didn't just pick, like, right heroes. Like, Slark doesn't beat Invoker in mid, I think. Especially with the Dazzle help, and Nature's Prophet doesn't win his lane against these two too, so... Like, I think they should have picked maybe different heroes or just played differently. Maybe put Sank, like, I'm not sure what they can actually do. Maybe even Terrorblade mid against Invoker.
I think Terrorblade would have been better at this point.
Yeah, and it seems like Terrorblade is going to jungle too, so, like... Both
three
of your
junglers.
Cores, yeah. And both of their cores doesn't get anything. I mean, Terrorblade and Nature's Prophet, yeah, they can jungle, but it's not what you want as your cores.
DP in. This Helix is stunned, there's no stun. Ice Bath is going to cancel everything. Dual Breath. Dual Breath, will he get the kill? Yes, they will get the kill. Sun Strike misses, the right clicks, the bounces, the Liquid Fire. Penguin just getting some damage done, but there's not much damage dealt to the Ogre since he has 7 armor and stat shield versus only 60 damage from Nature's Prophet. Actually, Ignite going on the Mega X, Ice Bath hits.
Oh, they're not diving. But the tower is low, so
yeah.
They're gonna get it fast.
Doesn't look like the Sunstrikes are gonna hit, but if they do, ooh, that's gonna be a lot of damage to all these squishy heroes.
Yeah, and once again in the last game, Quill is free farming and has absolute free
Fabian
farming.
Fabian gets jumped by the Slark, the Sunstrike.
Yeah. Oh, Slark? Oh no.
Actually dodged with the...
Oh, double damage, I didn't even notice.
Yep.
Nice.
Looks like easy kill for the Slark. And
Slark killed him
kills.
Twice, but still Invoker has 700 more net worth. So,
Q11
yeah.
going and tasting the wrath of the Quill. Drow Ranger, maxing the aura.
Yeah, and as they told, he has complete free farm once again, and it's not the player which you want to have free farm on against playing against him.
Yeah. It seems like the Radiant team are just outclassed at this point. It looks
yeah.
like a tier 1 team versus tier 3. They just get.
And look at it, at 7 minutes in, there's already 5,000 net worth change in net worth difference in a graph, so yeah.
And it's about to go even more since the tower is down.
Yeah.
It looks like just outplayed, really. Outdrafted, outplayed, outmaneuvered, outrotated.
And Fabian once again in mid lane.
Will he die? Yes,
oh,
he will.
Wow. Slark actually killing 3 times Fabian. That's really weird from Fabian. Like, he's one of the, probably one of the best players in this tournament and doing that kind of plays. Not
yeah.
Sure.
Mm. Oh, and the ward is going to be dewarded as soon as they see him. Will they see it? Yes, they did. No?
Yeah, they did. No? Yes? He's got it. Yeah, he's it. He's
okay, fallen. Then. It's so sad being Radiant Team. Although the Slark can be that one saving grace as he jumps on the Jakiro Liquid Fire,
oh.
I mean, the Ulti Macro Fire, Ice Bath, they're dancing around the
he's
flames
gonna be dead.
And the ice. Oh. Durablade uses the Metamorphoses. Stun actually gets rid of the illusion. Good attempt by Slark, but there were 3 people waiting for him. Overall, this Slark can be the saving grace for the Radiant Team, but they have to
get. He has his levels. Has very, very much level.
Q11 being chased by the everyone really, and he goes down as the Dire Team just
yeah,
goes
and we
in.
Talked about 10 minutes blink dagger. He's nowhere close to it. He has like 600.
The grave
yeah.
actually helps him.
Oh,
survive.
what a word from Witch Doctor.
Ooh, jumping in the drow, as we say in Lithuanian, from a wolf to a bear, or something like that. Jumping from a wolf to a bear, which is Quill, he goes down.
And Ogre just stood in the Witch Doctor's ward, like, for ages. He was just standing there.
I don't think he cares, actually.
Well, he thought he's that tanky, but, well.
Yeah, there goes the middle tower, and Loke grabs that kill. He's
oh, and top lane, Nature's Prophet's dead.
It's just so hard for him to play this game, actually. When
yeah.
you have a Drow Ranger with Gus who cancels your TP.
And that's why, as I was mentioning, like, we were talking about sanking 10 minutes in, Blink Dagger, team fights easy. He's nowhere close, he has 600 gold, that's 1.5 thousand away from his blink.
The legs going against the Slark. Slark is gonna get some damage, and I think
yeah,
the legs
probably
dead.
Ooh,
oh. The ice wall, the gold snap. Everything is going
oh,
in.
Nice,
Kovalda.
Nice.
Sunstrike, is he gonna set? No, he has an open cooldown. Yes, he does.
Yeah.
Good protection from Fabian dying 3 times to solo Slark. But
I should terribly the. Started farming and catch up a lot.
He still needs. CS. He still needs a lot of farm.
Yeah, but like as the, on the like you have 50 CS on Terrorblade and which is not that bad, but you have 85 CS on your Drow Ranger. So, it's and 2 kills too and 3 towers. So his net worth is gonna be like.
Bottom lane, Penguin just being away from this Slark as they have no stuns to stop him. Then there's Ice Pass, Macro Fire, everything
but
on
Slark
the Slark. No, he's actually not.
Oh.
Ooh. Will he
oh,
die?
Ult.
Yeah, he's gonna go ulti. Ice Path hits. The Dual Breath. He's
dead.
He shouldn't have turned around.
Yeah.
Which Doctor sees the Bacardi. I think Drow Ranger can easily take down the Roshan now, as they're
yeah.
gonna do actually.
He's going to do that.
Yeah.
He has
Bacardi chasing down the 2 people of the Radiant Team, and now we have the Ease Rosh.
Yeah. And Drow Ranger has almost 7,000 net worth in a 12 minutes game. It's actually really, really insane. And Volker got 5,000 and it's doing it to towers and. Gonna become even more when they pick up the Rosh. Yeah.
This Roshan just melts at this point.
Even the D on Ogre.
Yeah, they should have given it to the Drow Ranger. That's over like, that's 400 damage per hit, really.
Yeah.
And it looks like tier 2 is going to be the.
And it's just a bit Stork. Nope.
Yule's happening, then the Ice Bath, Dual Breath, Macro Fire, everything on the. Nature's Prophet, but he's gonna.
Which Doctor saving again?
The tower is gonna melt now.
Still, yeah.
Drow Ranger is ridiculous on pushing. As long as well as the Liquid Fire. Looks like they wanna fight. The Slark wants to fight. The Radiant Team doesn't. Midas. Ooh, a Nature's Prophet, Midas. I don't find that good. I personally think he should have went for 4 null talismans for that early game. And it looks like the Dire team actually wants to take down the
Yeah, there's
rats.
Nothing they can, to stop us, because Sanking is nowhere close to his blink, and Terrorblade doesn't even have his metamorphosis up. So
the stun on one, and I saw the ward actually go. Slark actually comes in, kills one, goes for the another one. Will he
but
die?
The damage from the Drow Ranger.
Drow Ranger dealing damage. Dual breath on the Slark. Slark is going to survive, but not for long as Quell.
Oh.
Just rains fire. Ooh, boom, boom, and there Let's goes the Nature's Prophet. And the only hero to be alive is the Sand King, which is not going to do much unless he sells his boots, and I don't think that selling boots is the correct answer, as Quell still has the Aegis. He's gonna go right click the arrangement barracks down.
Yeah, and
why is Fabian not actually pushing the top lane?
He's
and
just
there
wandering
goes the
around.
There goes the Rax. Although only range, but that's... You have a Drow Ranger with the position aura and also the mega range shape.
Yeah,
super
already
range
10,000 net worth from Drow Ranger, and it's really, really good. Good game from Quell.
Yeah, he knows this hero. I think he loves the hero, but I'm not sure. I think he's gonna go for the Sage Yasha next. I mean, Sage. Oh, actually, he's gonna go for the Butterfly, which is fine. He doesn't really need to tank up since there's no urgency. But eventually, he will get the Sage Yasha.
Really much damage from four others with the Butterfly.
Multicasting with the Ignite. Dual Breath on the creeps. Stun! Casting everything on the
epicenter? Oh, but the Yules. Self Yules, actually.
Slark trying to catch Fabian, but the combo from the Invoker
gets
down.
Oh, nice ward. But. Oh, no.
No, it's over.
The hero just had like 24 armor with us.
Quell, still double damage. Rains down, death. And there goes GG. 50 minute GG.
Yeah, 50 minute, even faster.
Showing the class they have.
Yeah.
There's... So... The game went fast, actually. What happened?
I don't know.
Doesn't look like DOT was ready for this team.
Yeah.
Well, the scoreboard actually sums everything up. The Slark, the only one with kills alongside Witch Doctor, but he has only one kill. And actually, he has more fantasy points than the Slark.
Because of the healing. The healing counts too.
Yeah, I guess. So. Today we were guessing this game. I am TV Monitors. Follow me on Twitter or the Twitch channel, which you can find right here on the right side. And Yushi, he is going to be playing tomorrow at 8 p.m. our time, everyone's time basically. And you can see him there. And say bye.
Bye.
Bye. Yeah. GG. Well played.
Thankful for the life you got, you know what I'm saying? Stop looking at what you ain't got, start being thankful for what you do got. Let's get it to him, baby girl. Hey! Yeah.
reason they ungrateful. After all the game I gave away, safe to say I paved the way for you cats to get paid today. You'd still be wasting days away now had I never saved the day. Consider them my protege. How much I think they should pay. Instead of being gracious, they violate in a major way. I never been a hater. Still, I love them in a crazy way. Some say they sold the yay and know they couldn't get work on Labor Day. It ain't that black and white. It has an area that's shaded gray. I'm west side anyway. Even if I left today, it stayed away. Some move away to make a way. Not move away cause they afraid. I walk back to the hood. And all you ever did was take away. I pray for patience, but they make me want to melt their face away. Like I once made them spray. Now I can make them put the K's away. Been thugging all my life. Can't say I don't deserve to take a break. You'd rather see me catch a case and watch my future fade away. And the swagger of a college kid. Allergic to the counterfeit. Impartial to the politics. Articulate, but still a grab a nigga by the collar quick. Whoever having problems with their record sales, just holler till. If that don't work and all us fails, then turn around and follow till. I got love for the game, but hey, I'm not in love with all of it. Could do without the fame. And rappers nowadays are comedy. The hooting and the hollering back and forth with the arguing. Where you from, who you know, what you making, what kind of car you in. Seems as though you lost sight of what's important when depositing the checks into your bank account and you up out of poverty. Your values is in disarray, prioritizing horribly. Unhappy with the riches cause you're piss poor morally. Ignoring all prior advice and forewarning, and we mighty full of ourselves all of a sudden, aren't we?